So this is where the live stream will properly start on YouTube. We've got the Peruvian job here. I actually was sat in my new Crew Alexandra away shirt, expecting to actually do a proper edited video today, which kind of worked out well because we've got the Peruvian games to come here, Paraguay and Bolivia in the qualifying rounds. Let's just show you the table for the FIFA World Cup qualifiers. We're sitting in sixth. We're not that far off the like five top spots that either progress into the World Cup itself or do something else. I don't know. Maybe there's a knockout round afterwards, but with five teams, that's interesting. Maybe it's a smaller group. Who knows? Anyway, we are sixth. We have an outside chance. We're going to win all our games remaining, basically. And it's fallen quite well because I've got my next day off on Monday, and that is a couple of days until the end of this month, so I can get the early video to the patrons, which is great. But not only that, I can actually spend a little bit more time with you guys during the weekend because I am very busy at work this weekend, and I don't really think that there's going to be a video out at all other than this one, which is really poor. Yeah, it sucks. I'm sorry. I am really sorry for that. But sometimes it's just like it is, obviously, with it being just after Christmas. My bank account is not the healthiest, so I've just took up as much work as I possibly can at work. And, it stinks a bit. Here's the Peruvian shirt. Lovely. Look at that. And immediately we got a problem. Bloody hell. Right, we're going to have to play in that one. I'm not really that fussed to playing an away shirt at home. There's a bit less, It feels like there's a bit less strictness when it comes to kits in the national side. But the main thing, well, actually, the second main thing, let's back out of this. We're going too fast because we want to get to the team management screen. Firstly, we've got to put it in the 4-2-4 that we're all accustomed to. We don't want the 4-4-2 holding. We want the 4-4-2 flat. We want to cancel that. And then we'll just... Oh, no. Andre... Anybody who watched the Man United career mode that I did last year, you'll realise and remember that he was not very good at all. Looks like a great player, 83 overall, and he just did not do things for me. He was so bad. That's the guy. He's the guy that we can't wait to watch again, Squeezy, with his juices. Okay. I'm going to try and play as many regens as I possibly can. Even though it's going to make it even more difficult for me. Miguel Yotun will play this game, definitely. It's nice to see Miguel Yotun again. And there's a lot of people saying, oh, scout a lot more Peruvians. I will do. And we'll make sure that that happens. Although we haven't got that many spaces in the Crew Alexandra side yet. Maybe I'll just keep them in the youth academy. Maybe I'll do that. Okay, so Paraguay at home. We're going to go in this lovely red and white concoction, whatever the word means. And blah, blah. Peru against Paraguay. Change this up. So we've got Squeezy up front. What else we got here? This guy can go on the wing, even though he's 80 overall, him, so he stays. And Yotun can be replaced by Yotun. Interesting. And that's it. That's it. Squeezy, main man up front. Left-footed, so he goes there. That right-foot guy's not that bad. He is 30 years old, though. So, yeah, it's a very aging squad as well. So, we've got to kind of treat this side with a bit of care. Sandoval can start. There you go. So, we've got three regens starting. and they're both basically left side of the spine. So Squeezy Otton and Sandoval. A lot of scouting is needed. A lot of scouting. But a chance to get Squeezy into a World Cup, which is awesome. Let's get this going. Brazil are fifth. I don't know what on earth that's happened. 3 out of 10, not enough. St. Vincent and the Grenadines. Man, I live and breathe YSL. That's good. Put Squeezy in the first team, obviously. Why is Squeezy white in this screen? I have no idea. I really have no idea. And let me turn down my telly so you don't hear that. Yeah, it's just very strange, isn't it? All right, Squeezy number 27. It's very nice to see him. Oh, I get to play with him. That didn't sound right, but you know what I'm saying. Look at this. I did say to a guy who got back to me on the Patreon Skype chat, and he said, yeah, I'll choose Squeezy. I'll customize Squeezy. And I'm like, right, okay, well, I'm managing Peru, like, so he will be around. And he hasn't got back to me with customization options for him yet. So get it done. We've got an early free kick here, an early chance for Squeezy to whip. We ain't putting Carrillo on this. Where is he? Squeezy did score a free kick for Carrillo Alexander. It was the first free kick that we scored in the series. And this one wasn't as good. Nearly there. It was nearly there. I'm so glad that Squeezy is part of this team. It's amazing that the first ever international job came back as Squeezy. So, Sandoval here, 13. Doesn't look too bad, actually. But he's the best of the regens that haven't come through the crew system. I'd say system rather than academy, because I'm pretty sure Yotun and Squeezy were both free agents. Squeezy! Deflection. That will be a corner. But Squeezy's pure pace, getting the best of the Paraguayan defences already. So this should be a good game. And it should be a game that we need... Well, it is a game that we need to win. We need to win both of the ties, to be honest. Bolivia and Paraguay. To put pressure on fifth place Brazil. Can someone tell me how the group stage works? Is this Miguel Yotun? The actual Miguel Yotun? Nice. Galesa as well. Could you imagine if we had the proper Galesa? The Yeovil Town Galesa in this squad. That'd be lovely. Squeezy lining up his victims. Send it. There we go. And again, it's Miguel Yotun! Could you imagine if Miguel Yotun was the first goal scorer? Okay. Whip it in. Oh, I won a header. That is absolutely incredible. There, we got that. Even though I didn't rate him when I played with him, pretty sure we're going to have to get Carrillo more and more involved in this game. Alexander Rosenberg as Peruvian boss. Here we go. Is this it now? Are we going to get Carrillo involved? Is he actually better than last year? First, initial feelings is that he's not. A bit too sluggish. A bit too static as a winger, I feel. Miguel Yotun's had a solid 21 minutes.
Pressure's growing and growing here.
There we go. Oh God, that first touch was terrible. We got it. This is it. Squeezy. Can't play the ball back. I'd say we've had most of the opening stages. Okay, Yotun. hold it up. Very nice, lovely work. And again, yes, yes, top corner, that was really well played. It's not Squeezy, it's his strike partner in the number 9 shirt. And we will take that, because that was quality work by the Peruvian front line. And there we are. Excellent, really work. Oh my word. Did Squeezy, I think, did a back heel, a Meg's back heel, a Nutmeg's back heel. Can we just have a look at that? Because if he has done this, this is absolute dirt. Yeah. Just, not a back heel, but it's a lovely little pass. Through the legs! That is absolutely disgusting. And then Tapia, who's someone's claimed is an absolute legend on the stream. There he is. He's an absolute legend for making that assist. Great goal. Beautiful build-up, I agree. And that's exactly what we needed. Oh, my word. Paraguay just giving us the ball. Didn't actually check where Paraguay were in the table. I know Bolivia are very far down. Oh, game. Well into it already. There we go. Long shot, maybe. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. That was poor.
That's a dreadful effort. There was no need to try it from there, and that's miles wide. The goalkeeper, no problem with that.
Get him. Tackle. Great tackle. Perfectly timed. Can carry on. Go back. There we are. Miguel Yotun. Not the best of passers. Have the defence got actual work to do now? Maybe. No, we got that. We'll play it back. Left can smash it up. Down. Control with the chest. Oh, that was close. That was close. Very nice. We've won it back. That didn't work out at all. Oh my goodness, Paraguay are terrible. You think Peru are bad. Paraguay are absolutely atrocious. I've seen better play in League 2. Definitely. Under a slider setup that were worse.
Keeping possession. Couldn't get through.
And cover the wing. And cover this wing. They are going to go wide. Can just sense it. Hey, Sandoval, very well played, mate. Sandoval doing the business at the back. Liking that. Squeezy nearly loses out. Now he's completely out of position. But we are working this wonderfully well. Wonderfully well. That makes sense, doesn't it?
Loses the ball.
Down
and they may be short of cover if they're not careful.
Now all the potential is gone, they have to get the ball back once more.
Send it to the number 7, it's Miguel Yotun. And again, lads. Oh no.
Oh, that's some stop.
Close though, to a second. Absolute dominance by the men in red. And that is half time. That's actually half time. Alright. Let's have a little drink.
Ready to go again then for another 45 minutes.
Just realise the clock, the time. 5 o'clock nearly in the UK.
Making sure they keep.
I really want to watch Pointless, which is 5:15. We're definitely not going to be able to play two games in the meantime, or one and a half. So we might have to split this up. Obviously, if you're watching it on YouTube, I'll join it back together. You might have to join me again for the second game. Squeeze it. Get it wide. Get it wide. There we are. Ugh.
Couldn't keep hold of the ball.
I'm already making a kind of mental note on these players. Which ones are good, which ones are bad. Which ones haven't made an impact yet. I'd say Miguel Yotun has been really solid. There we go. Oh, what an awful ball to Squeezy. Maybe that was his chance. That was his time to impress. That's a great little piece of strength. And back. There we are. Hit it. It's gone for a corner. So, nice little defensive block there. Into the mixer. Squeezes there. Oh, 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 a back heel from Squeezy. Nearly worked out. Zambrano with an excellent cutting pass. Oh, he's just playing himself into trouble. Miguel Yotun's pressure works out in the end, but we still don't have possession of the ball. Sandoval, yes, mate. I like him. I really do rate him. And he's absolutely massive. Oi! Whoa. That was too close to call. Don't like that. Head up. Okay, we've lost a bit of the possession at the start of this second half. We need to calm this down. We do need to calm this down. There we go. Back on the floor. Nice and easy. We're in control. Lovely. And there's the through ball, and it's absolutely terrible. Squeezy's finding pockets. Channels. There you go. Not more channels than Sky. Whoa. Look at me. Being all funny and crap. Ruidas. Back. Get Carrillo into the game. He's onside. It's Carrillo. Get the cross right. Squeezy. It's still in. Should I have let that run for a corner? Probably. Get that into the centre. Miguel Yotun. Oh dear.
Just beginning to look at the clock now. Still 20 minutes.
That's a really nice ball to Squeezy. He's got a lot of work to do. And, yeah. He's been... You know what? Even though his movement's been great on the ball, he's been pretty disappointing. Probably won't be like that for Crew. I'm trying to work him into this Peruvian side. Obviously, it looks like he was third-choice striker. Oh... Come on then. Get the cross in. Oh, the number nine's done bits up front. Scored the goal. Nearly scored there. Cross comes in. It's a really awful one. But we'll have a second go. Sandoval. Okay. He got completely taken out of the game. Carrillo. Yes.
First of the ball is the goalkeeper.
Not a great idea. Was that a Turbe that came on for Paraguay? Should I make subs? People are getting very tired. That's a great block by Zambrano. Oh, right, okay. Last 10 minutes. I need to batten down these hatches. So we've got another centre-back. I think he has to be Sandoval that gets replaced. And then we've got a right-back. And then everybody else is a real player. Now, we'll bring on this left winger because the cam's been absolutely atrocious for us on the wing.
Credit the defender.
I have no idea. You know what? Twitch's connection to streamers is absolutely diabolical. Nothing is wrong with my internet.
Easily away.
And yet, I disconnect. And it's absolutely stupid. Hopefully you're all back with us.
So alert to see that and get to it.
I do apologise. Go on, send it wide.
Lost the ball. Vieira.
What a joke. Right, okay, we're into the last 5 minutes. We just need to calm this. Oh my goodness, don't do that to me. Great tackle. Oh, that was too much. What awful clearance by the keeper. Squeezy, look at Squeezy go. Come on, Squeezy. Let's do it now. Squeezy, keep it in. Into Carrillo, cross, header. Oh.
Gonzalez.
Paraguay pushing a lot of players forward. Yes, lads. Number 99. I'm guessing he's a free agent. Yes. Go on, make the run. Why is the number 9 not making the run? He had all the space in the world. Oh, my. Oh. We got this. We got this. Yes. Is that full time? It's blown up. End of the 90 minutes. It's a good win. The start of the Alexander Rosenberg reign as Peruvian manager. And let's just get the second game out of the way as well, instead of messing about. I'll only be a little bit late for Pointless. And yes, I did watch the 1,000th episode. Big Pointless fan. Love it. We can do the player development afterwards. Don't need to rush into that. So away against Bolivia. You know what? I don't know why this is locked on the match day. Because I'm playing the international match. That's always confused me. Ooh. It's a nice little combo there with the green and white. Let's just change this up. To Payot back into the midfield. Definitely going to have to play Squeezy again. This time with this kid, who's another right footer, so we'll take that. There'll be another Yotun on the left back spot. Miguel Yotun is pretty tired. Might have to skip this. The right mid. There you go. Or even Carrillo. Actually, Carrillo there. You know, so he gets more involved. It is Bolivia, so Zambrano might not need to play. I'm going to play Carrillo and Hurtado from the start. We should be alright here. Bolivia against Peru. That was quite difficult, the end of that game. I saw everything flashing before my eyes when the goalkeeper just decided to completely screw it up. But a great block. I think it was from Carrillo or Hurtado, the guys that came on from the bench, that made that block in the first place. We'll have a look at the league table, the group stage table, after we finish this game. Well, putting two wins on the board, expect us to be challenging. Oh, Squeezy! Maybe be in fifth place. There we go. Avia. Creo just waiting. We will make. Oh my word, that is the worst first touch.
Marquez.
It's the kind of quality of player that we've got available to us.
Castro.
No. Ronald Chavez for Bolivia, which is a shame. It's a great shot. A good opening shot by Bolivia. pretty sure this national team is got the ground on the highest above sea level of any other national team. Is that right? Sure, I'm sure that's actual fact. So maybe that comes into play, that we've got to kind of get used to the quality of air up here. Squeezy. Taken down, but fairly. Pass is absolutely awful, but we've got time to correct it. Into Squeezy. There we are. This is a channel. Oh! Massive opening there for Peru. Hurtado should knock this down, which he does. Not a very good pass.
Just put his foot through that clearance.
Great header. Just headed on. Really well done. There we are. Fake shot. Can't get in. Oh, he needs a Stucky with him, partnering him up front.
They do like to get the ball out wide when they can.
Carrillo with the strength. Two Carrillos working together in unison to knock down the number 32 of Bolivia. Because this is such a short national pool, a small national pool, we're expected, if we are to scout Peru, to get literally the same surname every single time. So there'll be a lot of Yatuns, a lot of Squeezes, a lot of Carrillos, I'm expecting. Maybe a Zambrano as well. Hopefully it's not completely awful, but I'm expecting it to be pretty terrible. And Bolivia have a chance. Oh, well done. Please. Oh, he's offside. I was a bit dangerous with that. The foot in the box. That definitely wasn't a penalty. Go on then. Squeezy! Oh, just knock it in. Oh, my word. Oh, shocker. Carrillo. Carrillo's not been too bad in the centre of midfield.
Really turning the screws here.
It was only like the first 26 minutes. Oh, he's getting there now. He's ticking. Squeezy's ticking. Carrillo into the box. What on earth was that? We're getting stretched here. Come on, Carrillo. Oh, that's wonderful. Galesa to smash it up front. Knock it. Squeezes offside. Okay. Thirty minutes into the game. Bolivia are probably the weakest in the whole group. So we need to sort it out. Bloody hell. Great defending there. I mean, it looked like an own goal, but I'm sure if the play continued, the goalkeeper would have saved that. So it would have been classed as really nice defending. Come on. This is it. Is this it? Is it actually it? Squeezy. He's still got it. And the pass is terrible. Knock it down. No. Wonderful work. He's dropping way too deep. Realise that. Squeezy dropping way too deep to receive this ball. Carrillo.
Avila.
Yes. That's a fair challenge, but I still couldn't get through. Oh, passing from Bolivia has been 90%.
Hurtado. Passing the ball, keeping it.
Okay. No. He's dragged wide.
Well, no complaints from many of his teammates there. They know.
Not good. Not good for my hero up front so far. Look at this. The marking on these wing backs. Fair enough, this number 2 is not doing a bad job. But number 16, one of the regens, Hurtado, is having a nightmare. Just push him away, man. Presuming the Bolivian possession has been really good. He's onside. He's not onside. Okay. I am really worried. Not a bit worried. Really worried. Get it to half time and then we can sort it out from the bench. But we definitely need to shore up the defence. Zambrano, if I put him on the bench, will be coming on. If I put him on the bench.
Martins.
Well, someone will have to get changed in this defence. Right, that will mark the half time. Mark the half-time whistle? I don't know. Heads all over the place. That defence was terrible. Okay, another Asquez on. And Zambrano. And this lad that actually scored for us. Three changes, half-time. Need to get a win here. Away against Bolivia.
Castro loses the ball.
Really nice. Carrillo should have gone himself, I think.
Asking questions of the defense.
Your son.
So many players up with him.
Tapia. Where's Tapia going to find his next pass? All right. This is it. All or nothing, isn't it? Can't win away against Bolivia. How on earth are we thinking that we're going to get qualified for the World Cup? It's an absolute no-no. Help us out here.
Made the interception. Got it back too easily there.
That's it. Bit more assured from that defence.
Tacking down the flags now. What a foot to the ball. Tap comes to nothing. They've got to be careful not to get caught on the break here.
Oh, offside, offside. We don't need to chase it.
But now they have to get back and get the shape.
Play's been stopped.
Squeezy's missing the Squeezy-Stucky partnership. Yeah, that's true, but I don't think we'll be able to tempt Stucky to be a Peruvian. Try and find some Peruvian roots in his genes. Oh, well, it's onside. It's onside. It's on target. Onside? Where did onside come from, Curtis? Back to Carrillo. Let's get him moving. Get Carrillo moving. Oh, now then. It's just a mess in that defence. Castro for Bolivia has made 5 tackles. What on earth?
Picked off the pass. Possession changing hands here.
This is getting a bit desperate. Really is getting a bit desperate. Ruidaz. I'm going to call him Ruidaz. Should be Ruidaz.
Loses the defender.
Zambrano should have this.
Can someone reach it?
Cross is in.
Good ball in.
It's not dealt. Don't do that to me. Bolivia, yet again. Goalkeeper's had a great game. Get it out. Get it out.
Not a good pass. Easily picked off. He'll shoot.
Oh, my.
Oh, good hand.
Oh! That was too close.
Loose.
Come on, lads. Find something.
Santos.
Still 20 minutes to go, enough time for all
apparently
things to happen.
There was a foul, and that's head down, out, and away. Bolivia on the front foot at the moment. It's less than 20 minutes to go. I think it might be time to push this onto ultra attacking, even though attacking didn't work. Attacking really didn't work, did it? Oh my, the first touch. Right. Attacking didn't work.
That run was far too blatant. He's just
go back to balance. Then in the last 10 minutes, all out attack. Here we are. Squeezy. My goodness. It's not getting any luck so far. This kid's onside. Can't get it out wide. Our play in the second half has been absolutely dreadful. We still believe. Come on, lads.
Could be dangerous. Crossed it to the danger area. Solid defending.
Oh my word. Big tackle there. By another Yotun. That circle, that clearance, was meant to be a tackle. And instead, I cleared it about 5 yards down the line. Come on, Ruidas. Let's get this right. Oh, go on then. Oh! Closest that we've gone. Or is it? No, Squeezy hit the post in the first half, didn't he? Closest that we've gone in the second, anyway. Go on then. There's masses of space. Yes. Yes. No. Head it down. Tapia. Yeah. We still got it. Calm. Oh my word.
He's been robbed.
It's not been there for us in this game.
Martins. This man won't want to come off, but he's just looking a little tired now.
Great tackle.
Past him too often.
Excellent.
He's running the show.
Go on, this guy's onside. Play him. Oh, Squeezy with a last minute winner would be just tremendous.
Campos.
How on earth have we been... Oh, yes, Squeezy! Yeah! As if that's happened! Yes! Oh! Ugo! Yes! Oh, get in! Well, that was a bit good, wasn't it? Oh, wow.
Both teams had virtually settled for the draw, take their chances with extra time, but that goal's changed everything.
That was decent. And that will be full time as the last attack of the game. Squeezy wins it for us against Bolivia. Oh my goodness, that was too close to call. We need to win matches quicker and easier than that. Ay, ay, ay. But we'll take it. Here we are, Bolivia 0, Peru 1. Ugh. Good. Right, let's have a look at the World Cup qualifying table. That's the results and fixtures. That's the other leagues. Okay, sort yourself out. Tables. World Cup qualifiers. We are up in third. All right. That's good enough for me. I can't believe Brazil are down in sixth. That's absolutely ridiculous. But Peru in third, 15 points, 4 points behind Argentina. We're well on the way now. And Alexander Rosenberg turning this ship around quickly. There we are. Hopefully you've enjoyed this live stream and the video that subsequently will be put on YouTube. If you've enjoyed it, then please give the video a like. And I will see you next time. Thank you ever so much for anybody who's watched me live. Alright guys, see you in a bit.